Hey yo, it's Brian here. Today, talking about the San Francisco 49ers. In this one, going to be talking about the NFC West and going to be doing a series with all the positions, ranking them from 1 through 4 for the division. Top 1 is number 1. Number 4 is last, obviously. So this particular video is going to be about quarterbacks, who's the, I guess, quote-unquote, worst ones. I think all these quarterbacks are very talented in their own way. They're pretty good quarterbacks, in my opinion. Yes, even one of the quarterbacks that I kind of bash sometimes, but he's still a pretty good quarterback, in my opinion. But yeah, so ranking them 1 through 4, a little bit challenging. And we'll see where that takes us to. Hope you guys had a great Tuesday. Nothing too crazy going on right now. Hopefully everybody's staying safe as much as possible from this whole sickness thing. I wish we can just get through this eventually, and we will get through this eventually. So, yep, going to get the video started. But before I do, as always, please like and subscribe. That's going to definitely help me out a lot. Click that bell notification, get notified of future videos. Share the channel, share this content with fellow Niners faithfuls. Check out my website for articles about the 49ers and NFL in general. That would be much appreciative. Let's get this started. 49ers and NFC West, ranking the quarterbacks from 4 through 1 in this particular video. Right now, the quarterbacks for the NFC West, obviously Jimmy Garoppolo is number 1, not number 1 ranking, but that's our guy. Number 2, Russell Wilson, that is Seahawks quarterback. Number 3, Jared Goff, Rams quarterback. Number 4, Kyler Murray, Arizona Cardinals. So let's rank them right here, right now. So starting at number 4, not too difficult, but I'm going to say Jared Goff. I mean, he's a talented quarterback. He has a good, pretty decent arm, but at the same time, I think he's quote-unquote the worst quarterback in the NFC West. And I think 2019, he got exposed big time and in the Super Bowl. I mean, I think a lot of teams have taken advantage of the Patriots' play calling and everything. Bill Belichick exposing him a little bit for just being a system quarterback, you want to call it. Also, he's very reliant on Sean McVay in terms of play calling. He's not really creative, not like the other quarterbacks like Russell Wilson and Kyler Murray. Those two guys, they're very creative in terms of moving around the pocket, improvising. I don't think Goff's that type of guy to do that. I think he needs a really good team around him, which the Rams, for the most part, they've done a good job on giving him nice pieces. I mean, they do have some great tight end pieces. They have some great wide receiver pieces. They did have Todd Gurley for a bit when he was good. But other than that, I think Goff, although somewhat talented, I don't think he's the best quarterback in the West. I think he's the worst in the NFC West. But in terms of the NFL, I think he's a little above average, and that's what my stance about him right now. So Goff, I'm not the biggest fan of his. I never was a big fan of his, and I don't know. He can only take him as far as they want him to take him to. Last place in the NFC West, but no knock on him. I mean, the other quarterbacks, in my opinion, are better than him, and that's all I have to say. Number 3, this was a toss-up between Jimmy G and Kyler Murray. I know, right? Really, really confusing right there. But number 3, I'm going to be putting Kyler Murray just because he is just getting started. I mean, you could say the same thing about Jimmy G, but I think Murray, first year, rookie year, we need to see more of him. And he's subject to go even higher on this list, on my personal list, in the next year or two. But just for right now, this offseason 2020, he's shown a lot of promise from the last season in 2019. He's done a lot of great things. He had two very good games against the 49ers, and they were a pretty good defense, especially the first meeting in Arizona on Thursday Night Football. That was a big surprise right there for him to do really well in that situation. But yeah, I think he can get a little bit better. Is he going to be a victim of the sophomore slump? I don't know yet. A lot of people were victims of it. Dak Prescott, he was a pretty big victim to sophomore slump. Baker Mayfield as well. So Murray, is he going to be on that path? Is he going to be in the better path? We don't know yet, but so far, I'm just going to be putting him number 3 right now for the offseason, but subject to change. Maybe in the middle of the season, I'll change my stance on Murray, but so far, he's proven me wrong. I was not a big fan of his coming out of what school did he come to? Oklahoma and Cliff Kingsbury, I wasn't a fan as well, but they're proving me wrong right now, so I got to give them a lot of credit for what they've done. So right now, they're just ranked a little bit low because they need a little bit more experience, and you know, they can change anytime. So Cardinal fans, please take it that way. Number 2, I think Jimmy G, quarterback. I mean, he could be number 1 eventually, but for right now, just like Murray, he's just getting started. But Jimmy G, he's been able to learn under Tom Brady, under Bill Belichick. He's had a couple of starts in New England. He had some starts in San Francisco for the past couple of years, and then he finally completed his first full season as the 49ers starting quarterback and a starting quarterback in the NFL in general. He took the team to Super Bowl 54, or helped the team go to Super Bowl 54. Defense was awesome, but G, he had a good way to go in the regular season. I expect him to get even better as seasons progress, minus any injuries or anything like that. The team is pretty good around him, and even before that, 2017, 2018, when he was with the team, when he first started, he changed the team differently. I mean, when you look at Brian Hoyer, CJ Beathard, they weren't doing the best jobs, and then when Jimmy G took over in 2017, the last couple of games, he did a really fine job. He was the franchise quarterback savior for us, and I still think he is that type of guy a couple of years later, so never really changed my stance on that. For me, he's still a little bit raw. As you all know, turnovers, they're really annoying. He's probably the worst turnover quarterback in this whole list right here, but We'll see in the next couple of years if he can improve upon that. I don't know if it will. I think it's going to be more of a Brett Favre type guy where he's just going to throw an interception. You have to expect it in any game. Hopefully it's really early on in the game and then he can make a nice comeback later on. So Jimmy G, number two. I want to put him at number one, but he's not there yet. But I think he will, hopefully by the end of 2020. And number one, as you all know, Russell Wilson. I mean, this guy has been a hindrance and annoyance to us in San Francisco when both teams are really good. I mean, he almost won the NFC West for them last year in that last game. But luckily, Dre Greenlaw helped save our day. But yeah, Wilson, playmaker. I mean, I can't say anything else about him. I mean, I hate him, but I got to respect him definitely. Well, I don't hate him like that, but you know, he is annoying in our matchups that we do face him. I mean, the last two games in 2019, he did a really good job in both those games. He's done a great job for the past couple of years in Seattle ever since 2012. I mean, I don't think he's ever had a losing season in Seattle. I think they have 1-9-7 season, but that was pretty much it. But yeah, he's been able to do a lot. MVP type quarterback. I mean, you want to talk about the definition of MVP, a guy to take nobodies into somebody's. That's definitely Wilson, because without him, Seattle, I don't even think they'll be good at all, to be honest with you. They do have some talent on the team, but without Russell Wilson, the Seahawks would be pretty irrelevant, in my opinion. But yeah, he's a big difference maker on that team. So Wilson, got to give him a lot of credit, got to give him my respects. Everyone in San Francisco, I know he's not our favorite quarterback, but at the same time, you do have to give him a lot of respect for what he's done for the past couple of years in Seattle. And yeah, I'm going to keep it like that. So yep, that's my list right there, you guys. Not too hard of a list. This is just my opinion. If you don't like it, then too bad, I guess. But yeah, next video is going to be about the running backs, then wide receivers. It's pretty much the same thing as my roster prediction. I'm going to go in order of positions, and this is what I believe the quarterbacks are, the rankings in the NFC West coming into this 2020 campaign, and always subject to change, but we'll see then. I'm gonna end the video right here, you guys. Please let me know what you guys think about the quarterbacks in the NFC West. I like to what you guys say in the comments below. If you guys like this, please like and subscribe. That's gonna definitely help me a lot. I'll be catching you guys up probably tomorrow on a Wednesday. I might go almost every day doing every single position, and then training camp should be coming up, preseason should be coming up, and then the regular season. Hopefully everything's as normal, but we'll never know for the next couple of months. I'll see y'all then. Bye guys, love y'all. Y'all have a great rest of your night. Go Niners all day. Okay.